I'm Simply Mike. Welcome to the Definitive Yo-Yo. In this episode, I'm speaking directly to you, the brand new player that doesn't know much about yo-yoing at this point. You don't know how deep the rabbit hole goes. So that's what this video series is about. It's a six-part series where I talk about three plastic yo-yos and three metal yo-yos that I think would be great for a brand new player. I've seen a few players enter this hobby, and they usually have the same two questions on their mind. One, where do I learn tricks from? Well, that's kind of easy. You can either get information, a downloadable checklist from Yo-Yo Expert, or they have a card that they can mail to you as well, where you just mark off and learn tricks in the order that they present. Or two, yoyotricks.com or Throwback Skill Toys. There's a few hundred videos on their website where you can mark your progression and keep moving forward. Pretty easy. The second question is this: what yo-yo do I get? Now, that's a little bit more difficult to answer because yo-yos are pretty subjective. You'll find out pretty quickly. But we also need to have a start point. So I have this first video dealing with what I think is one of the best starting yo-yos that's available. So have a look-see, and then we'll proceed. Also remember, if you don't want to miss any of it, click like, subscribe, and join the conversation. I'll see you on the other side.
Pretty basic and a simple presentation, but that's exactly what you need for this launching point. Welcome to it. This is the Definitive Yo-Yo. In today's video, we're talking your first step into a larger world. Again, this is part one of six. And today's yo-yo is the Fizz by Throwback Skill Toys, aka yoyotricks.com. Modern yo-yo involves terminology, factors, and mechanics that you are unfamiliar with. There's plenty of time to learn that, but it can be a little overwhelming in the beginning. Here's a little peek at what modern yo-yo involves. Complicated string tricks, a little hopping, a little slack action, things of that nature. And the modern yo-yo itself is a precisely engineered piece featuring aircraft-grade aluminum or sometimes even titanium at $300 or more a pop. There are friction-reducing bearings, a braking system and mechanism, increased quality, making the yo-yos precisely balanced and very nearly vibeless. What does all this engineering mean? Well, we get better spin times, better accuracy, and just a better experience overall. But before we get to that, we gotta start with the basics. The Fizz Yo-Yo is one or two steps above the dollar store, big box store yo-yos that only allow you to do one or two tricks. It is pretty basic, as I mentioned before, but it's a good basic. And there are a couple of features that make this particular yo-yo stand out a little bit over the rest. But we'll talk about that in a little while. In the meantime, what you want is something that's a little simplified. You may already know about DNA and finger spins, but this yo-yo isn't going to allow for that. As mentioned, this is from Throwback Skill Toys, aka Yo-Yo Tricks. There's promotional video on their website. Now later you'll learn about different yo-yo shapes, but for now, we're just breaking it down to two. The slim yo-yo profile for looping tricks, and then our wedge profile for string tricks. This yo-yo, the Fizz, combines both shapes so that you can get a little bit of both styles of play. The inside wall is high enough so that you can do a little looping, but it's also wide enough so that you can do a little string tricks, both of which are demonstrated here. One underrated feature is that this thing is low maintenance and low worry. The only thing you need to worry about is a couple of tricks and getting started. You don't need to know about loop problems, response problems, or string problems. You just get in, start throwing it, start learning. And here are a few of the colors. Check the stats. Now, I'll call the shape a hybrid because it blends both, as we mentioned. And at $12, that is not a bad investment for your first yo-yo. Good stuff. What makes this yo-yo ideal for you as a new player is that this thing can help you gain consistency. See, you're too new to identify string problems, bearing problems, or those loop problems that I mentioned earlier. So what you need is a yo-yo that's just going to keep going while you learn your craft. And that's what this yo-yo is good for. There was a problem that I encountered while getting this yo-yo. The string is way too short. Seems like it's made for children. But other than that, not too bad. Walking the dog, Eiffel Tower, rocking the baby, brain twister. All of these tricks can be done with little to no problem on this yo-yo. But don't get too happy. And there are contemporaries like the Yo-Yo Factory 1, the Crystal by Magic Yo-Yo, the First Base by Recess, the Replay, the K1 by Magic Yo-Yo, the Rebrand by Rain City Skills, and the Atom Smasher. But that is a little more advanced. We'll talk about that another time. And unfortunately, there are a few limitations to this yo-yo, like it's entry level. So the biggest limitation on it is the spin time. There are a couple of balance issues, like it turns on a bad throw. The novelty of this thing can wear off pretty quickly. And unfortunately, the strings that it came with were pretty bad. They wore out in a relatively short time, so extras was needed pretty quickly. One other caution that you need to be aware of is that this thing can come back aggressively and suddenly while you're working out a trick. You might want to chalk that up to the cost of doing business. But as you grow in your yo-yo collection and skill, you won't have to worry about it coming back on you too much, too often, or too frequently. Honestly, this yo-yo is easy to bypass. I was already in the hobby long before this thing got released, but it's still a credible option despite the fact that there are other yo-yos out here available to you. And like I've said before, this will get the job done. And that's because this yo-yo is specifically designed to get you through the first 10 yo-yo tricks. They say 10, but it's actually closer to 15. And this yo-yo will definitely help you achieve that goal. But, like I said before, it will wear out its welcome pretty quickly. The goal for this video and yo-yo is to keep it basic. But who wants to stay basic? We want to keep making progress, and the next video and the next yo-yo will help us do that pretty good. That'll be for next time, which will be up in a few minutes. So, I was trying to make an all-black version of this yo-yo by buying two and swapping the caps out. But a funny thing happened on my way there. We'll talk about that in the next video. In the meantime, this has been the Fizz Yo-Yo Review, a nice production by YoYoTricks.com or Throwback Skill Toys, whichever strikes your fancy. This yo-yo was designed for someone who absolutely has no experience with yo-yo. But if you got a little bit of experience, check out what we get into with the next situation. Alrighty then, I'm Simply Mike, and I will catch you guys out in the next video. Stick around. Don't trip. Stick around. Alright y'all, peace. Our last yo-yo was for the absolute beginner, with features that made it perfect for this purpose. But now, it's time for us to put one foot forward so that we can and our next yo-yo represents a step above basic. Oh yeah, welcome to part two. This is the Definitive Yo-Yo and I'm Simply Mike. And today we're featuring yo-yos for new players, a six-part series. Today's yo-yo is actually a re-release of a yo-yo that came out a little over 20 years ago. This is the Freehand One by Duncan Yo-Yos, the full yo-yo review of course. But, funny thing happened to me on the way to making an all-black version. This Failure is Unknown came out, so this is actually the Freehand One Unknown Edition yo-yo review. Get at me, son. Can we admit that dollar store yo-yos ain't sexy? And yo-yos in general are opposed to the world of technology that we live in now. Despite being opposed, yo-yos have advanced in recent years, and the counterweight is how that advancement has been manifest. The freehand and its aluminum counterparts are called the first counterweight yo-yos. I don't know if that's true, but what I do know is that it's good for 5A. And there are a lot of them, like the intro levels, the classics, the Zero, the Freehand Pro, the Next Gen, our aluminum joints, and finally, the titaniums. I couldn't begin to tell you what the subtle differences are between models, so don't ask. But what I will say is that the Freehand One seems to be the one that most people gravitate towards. And this is how we can take the caps off. Warning, this will be loud. So I started with this yo-yo and ended up with this. And then my second one was gonna be all black. And what you'll need is a bicycle pump, some tape to make an airtight seal, and a set of pliers to remove the axle. And here we are. And let's admit it, that's pretty fire. As a step above basic, we have some contemporaries that we can put alongside our Freehand One, like the Shooting Star, the Atom Smasher, the rebrand by Rain City Skills, and the Punk that will be released soon, the Crystal by Magic Yo-Yo, and the Mile Hybrids, all of which are nice. But, hey, that unknown version speaks to me, daddy. The yo-yo itself is dope, but that clear counterweight, oh man, that is an inspired choice. I definitely have to learn some 5A, because this is the favorite of the Instagram crowd. Last video, we talked about the yo-yo allowing you to cover the basics, and this yo-yo allows that even more so. I'll explain why in a second, but here we are, knocking out the basics on this. It is responsive, so that is something that you have to contend with. But before we get into the whys and wherefores, let's check the stats. This is still a basic yo-yo, but it is way better suited for what we're doing. However, it's not really suited for the most advanced tricks. Now, what makes this a superior yo-yo? Now, the Fizz is a dope yo-yo, but its primary focus is on thread it and forget it. Not much to do as far as maintenance or anything like that. The Freehand, on the other hand, is not quite full size, but still modern enough. We have response pads in here, a longer axle, and we got a decent size bearing. Not quite industry standard, but it does get us in the vicinity. It may seem insignificant, but those touches allow for a bit more wiggle room when you're doing some tricks, making it much easier to play with. Now, you can swap out that bearing and make it unresponsive, but I don't recommend it. Otherwise, how would you get that maximum dramatic impact? Overall, a much better experience than the Fizz, but it's still got a few limitations. It's plastic, so there's a little limitation in the spin department, but not too much. And if you really want to go in with both feet, you might want to upgrade. This is definitely a step above basic, but there are a couple of steps further that we can go. This, however, is a really, really good yo-yo. Even though I'm late to the party, I am glad I have arrived, because this yo-yo is definitely worth it. And that's it. We'll check out what we get into for next time. Now, with both feet firmly placed in the camp of modern yo-yo, we're going to check out this yo-yo, which is about as modern a plastic as you're going to get. The Mojo. That video will be up in just a second. But this has been the Freehand One Unknown Edition Yo-Yo Review. Dopeness. For real. And I hope you got your hands on one. If not, oh well. Sorry about that, but that's your fault. Alright y'all, I'm Simply Mike, and I will check you guys out in the next video. Stay tuned, because it's coming right up. Ah yeah. Welcome to part 3 of our 6-part series where we examine entry-level yo-yos. That's available to you right now. Hi, I'm Simply Mike, and this is the Definitive Yo-Yo. If you haven't watched the previous 2 videos, please do so, because we're going to be building on what we learned in those. Today's yo-yo is a modern classic. It is the Mojo by Tapio, and I'm going to do a full review on it as well. Tapio is doing the heavy lifting for this video. They are the other budget brand out of China. But let me start by saying low tech is not sexy. Unsavory as that might appear, we live in a world of high tech, future tech, and bleeding edge tech. Even retro tech may seem like a bit of a novelty, but low tech, well, that's more of a choice. And at this level, low-tech represents a bit of a commitment. The reason being, because you gotta know how to bind. Like so. In modern yo-yo, you can't even consider yourself being involved in it if you don't know how to bind. It serves as the preeminent foundation for what modern yo-yo is. All the kiddies like DNA nowadays, but you have to know how to bind in order to pull that off. And with just a little learning, now the world of yo-yo opens up to you. But let's check some of the colors of what we're dealing with for this Mojo. There is some variety. Me personally, I prefer the yellowish, greenish, almost glow-in-the-dark fluorescent. This is a better representation of what we're talking about. And the yo-yo is based off the Salinas. They have the same shape and profile, but just a little different going on with the cup inside the Salinas. But it's not colorways that make this yo-yo stand out. We'll talk about that a little later. However, there is the Palm version that just recently dropped. Haven't had a chance to play it, but at the price point it is, it's not a bad haul if you can get up on one. To understand what makes this yo-yo special, We have to know Eastern yo-yo culture, where their yo-yos are fixed squarely on competition, and the yo-yos are a little thinner and different. Sort of like a muscle car versus a tuner. It's not better or worse, just different. And the two yo-yos, the Salinas and the Mojo, were both made for a Western audience. They are a wider, rimmier, and a little spinnier. So it appeals to a Western audience and a Western sensibility. Right about now, let's check the stats. A super great value at $14. And unlike the last two, this is a fully modern yo-yo, requiring all of that modern attention. So, let's check out some contemporaries. We have the Replay Pro, the Speedaholic XX, with finger spin caps, of course. We also have the Atom Smasher. Haven't played that one, but quite a few people have gotten up on it. We also have the DeCapo, one of my favorites from last year. This is not quite there, but the Surveil. It's dope plastic, but it's more hybrid. And Mile comes through with a few other ones, the MRL 3, 4, and 5. We'll talk about one of those in a later video. As mentioned, once you learn how to bind, your options for yo-yos opens up pretty wide. But the Mojo continues to be a credible option because of its price and its performance. Again, this is one of the best plastics, especially at that price point. So what are we talking about here? Well, as far as its play is concerned, we have a weighty plastic, but it's not so heavy that it lags. We have good control and maneuverability. Its wide stance makes it excellent for catching and riskier combos. Now, it is supposed to be good for finger spinning the horizontals, but I'm not quite there yet. Suffice it to say, this is an all-around great plastic yo-yo. And because it's plastic, you can ding it just a little bit. But right about now, we're going to learn how to do some finger spins. And it's going to take a while. Dagnabbit. I'll see you at the end. See, this is why I don't learn a lot of tricks, because I'm trash. Takes me a while to get something going. I felt like I needed to change over to the Speedaholic because that one seemed a bit more user-friendly for finger spins. But it still took a while. Coming for you, gentry. Yeah, that was fun. But check out what we get into for next time. We looked at our three plastic yo-yos, but now it's time to get into some beginner metal yo-yos. And we'll do that in a week or two. Until then, kiddies, this has been the Top Yo Mojo Yo-Yo Review. A lot of O's in that. Alright, I'm Simply Mike, and I will catch you guys in the next video. The next series, because I'm doing three in a row, just like this one. All right, y'all. Peace.